Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use OpenAI API with Java Spring Boot. So first I'll be showing you how to use it with plain Java, later with Spring Boot. So let's get started. The prerequisite is going to be you must have IntelliJ IDEA as well as Java installed on your system. If you don't have that, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. So first thing, just Google OpenAI API and you will be having the OpenAI platform. Click it and make sure that you are signing in. Here we are having libraries. Select it. And here if we scroll down, we are having the official SDK for Java. And here we are having the Maven dependency sample and also a sample code, how we can connect with it. And in case if you want to get more insights about this, here we are having learn more on GitHub. You can just open it. And here we are having the OpenAI Java. And if you scroll down, they're having some sample code for so many functionalities. If you want, you can just go through it. So now let's go and create a Java project. Just go to IntelliJ and select new project. Here, make sure that you are checking Java and just name it. And here in the build system, change it to Maven. And this is fine. Let me go with the default settings and click on create. So now let's get started by adding the dependencies. So here we are having the dependency, right? So you can just copy this. And you have to go into your pom.xml file. And here, just come to the next line. It's going to be dependencies. And inside it, you have to just paste it. All right, you have to paste your dependencies, whatever you have. So at first, I guess it will be throwing you some errors. So once you're done adding it, make sure that you are clicking this icon. You just need to select sync Maven changes. This particular icon will be getting automatically displayed. So just click here. And yeah, this will take some time. So once you do that, all your errors will be going. So once you're done adding this, come to main.java. We need to add our OpenAI API code. So for that, go here. You can simply like copy the entire thing, but I will just copy this at the moment and remove the system stuff inside it and just paste it. So once you're done pasting it, make sure that you are like importing everything like this. And here you can change the model. So if I just remove this and dot, and we can choose any one of these models available over here. So I'll just go with GPT-40 mini for this. So you can choose the model of your choice. And next thing is, as you can see here, we have got the chat completion response getting stored in this variable, but they are not printing or doing anything with it. So for this normal Java code, let's just print the response, all right? So I'll just come here. It's going to be a string, of course, the text. It's going to be string, and let me just have it as response. So it's going to be this chat completion variable. It's going to be chat completion dot, it's going to be choices dot get first, or you can just go with the zeroth index, both works fine, dot message dot content. Yep. This is basically the code, but it will throw like optional errors because it's an optional string. So for that, you can just have an or else condition, like or else. You can just have it as like a word empty, or you can just have no response, something like that in the or else. That's totally up to you. And the next line will be just using the print statement. So it's going to be system dot out dot print, and it's going to be the response. And let me just go and change the prompt. This is the input prompt that we are basically giving. So we can just like change it. So I've just given the prompt 100 line essay on global warming. So we are done with the code and the basic setup. And the most important thing is we need to link our OpenAI API key, because OpenAI is not free. So here, if you see in this code, this basically gets all the credentials from the environment variable itself. They have like automatically implemented that. So basically, you just need to add your OpenAI API key in the environment variable. It automatically fetches it into the code. So for this, you can just like go here, and I hope you know to get your OpenAI API key. And if you don't have that, or if you don't know how to get OpenAI credits or the API key, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. I've done an entire tutorial on it. So if you have done that, you need to just go to your profile over here. You need to go to profile and you need to select API keys, and you'll be getting the screen like this after you pay and buy credits. So here, just click on create new secret key. Just go with Java and select a project, create secret key, and finally you can just copy the secret key over here and select done. And in case if you want to delete it, you can delete it. That's totally up to you. So in the GitHub, they have given a sample code how we can use the API key. So either we can just set it in an environment variable, or if you want to just directly use it in the code itself, this is how you need to set up. You need to just add your API key over here. So for this example, let me just go and add it in the environment variable. And to the top, you'll be having this current file, right? Click it and select edit configurations. And here, click on this plus, select application. And here you need to select the main class. So click here, select this and click on OK. It'll be getting added. And here is the part where we will be adding our environment variables. Select this plus, it's going to be in caps, OpenAI underscore API underscore key. And here we need to paste the key that we have copied earlier. So just paste it. This is fine. Click on OK. And make sure that you are pressing apply. And OK. Now we are done. And here we will be having the resources folder. Right click, new file. It's going to be application.properties. And here we need to type spring.ai.openai.api-key, and here we need to paste our the environment variable that we are using here. So it's going to be $openai_api_key within curly brackets like this. So now we have done everything. So let's go to main, and for running this, you can either run this or click on this run button over here. So now in the console, we need to get the response, basically, which is a 100-line essay on global warming. And we have got the response here, and as you can see, this is a 100-line essay on global warming, which means that we have successfully implemented the code. So this is for plain Java, and now let's see how we can integrate this with Spring Boot. So first, let's just go and create a Spring Boot project. For that, you can just go to Spring Initializer, just Google it, and you'll be getting the first link. Click here. And here we need to make some configuration changes. First thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to change the project from Gradle to Maven. The language is going to be Java. I'm fine with this Spring Boot version. And next we can change the name. I'm fine with the default name. I don't care about it. And next we need to change the Java version. I'm going with 21. And next we need to add the dependencies. So for this, obviously we will be requiring the Spring Web, which gives us the REST controller, those stuff. So you can just add it. And next I'll be using Lombok, which helps us to reduce the boilerplate code. And apart from this, we'll be adding another dependency, which is our OpenAI dependency. So at the moment, this setup is fine. So let me just go and click create. And it will be getting downloaded as a zip file. We need to extract this. So here I'm having the downloaded file. I will just extract files here. So let's open the Spring Boot project. It's going to be open here, and just select it. Select the project and select OK. And click Trust Project and open it in a new window, because we can easily copy the code from the normal Java one into here. And this will take some time to index the files. So just be patient till then. And let's just test if our application is running. So just go to this expand everything, expand source, main Java, and we'll be having our application name Java file. Can just click on this run button and check if this is working. And as you can see, the application has started on port 8080, so the basic setup is fine. So first thing, we will be creating three files. It's going to be a config file, the controller, and the service file. The config file will be having basically this code, the OpenAI client code. So using that single config, we can reuse it all over our Spring Boot application. So that's the reason for having a config file. And next one is going to be the controller. So controller, we'll be defining our path, and the service file will be having our main logic. So by logic, service will be having this code over inside that. So now let's just go and create three new folders and three new files inside it. So just come here inside this example.demo, right click, create package, and it's going to be config. So I have created three folders, config, controller, and service. So before getting into the code, we can just quickly copy our environment variable that we had in our previous Java stuff. So we can just go here, edit configuration, and here we are having the environment variable, right? Copy it all and click on OK. just come here, same edit configuration, you can just go here and just paste it. Make sure that you have pasted well the format, so you can just apply everywhere. And next we need to also add in application.properties. So just copy this, and in the Spring Boot code we can just go into our resources. We'll be having application.properties file already there. You can just paste it here also. So now let's set up our OpenAI config file. So for that we are having the config, right click and new, select Java class and just name it as OpenAI config. So it's going to be OpenAI, and you can just have it as this. It's going to be a class. Hit enter and you'll be getting that code. So here first thing we need to have the config annotation. So it's going to be at, we'll be having configuration. So configuration, yeah, just have this annotation to define it as a config file. And next one, we need to access this variable that you are using here in our code. So for that, we can just have it as private string. And let me just have the variable name as OpenAI API key. So we need to access the API key here. So it's going to be at value and then curly brackets. We need to pass the exact name that we have given over here. So we can just like copy this and put it inside the curly bracket. So it needs to be something like this. Yeah, that's good. And next we need to define our bean. So before adding the next set of config code, we can just quickly configure our OpenAI in the Maven dependency. So because we'll be getting that recommendation and it will be easy to code for us. So we can just copy this, the same dependency, and go to pom.xml. And here we will be already having some dependencies added, like the Spring Web and Lombok. So we can just go here to the end, under dependencies, just paste it. And we'll be having this sync Maven changes automatically coming. Click it. And it will just, you know, get these dependencies added. Yeah, indexing, and that's done now. So now we can go to our OpenAI config. And here we need to create a bean. So it's going to be public. And it's going to be OpenAI client, so we'll be getting this recommended automatically. So that's the reason why I had to add the dependency and then code. It's going to be OpenAI client, and next line is going to be return OpenAI. We are having this OKH HTTP client, right? Select it, dot builder dot API key, and this is the place where we will set our API key that we have in this variable. So we can just copy this and put it inside here, dot build. All right, so this is going to be our config code. And don't forget to add the bean annotation. Come here, it's going to be at bean. All right, so that's it. We are done setting up our config code. Next, let's move on to our service code. So for creating a new service file, right click the service folder, new Java class, and just name it as OpenAI service. Can name anything, I'll just have it as OpenAI service over here, and it's going to be of type class. That's it, that's good. And first thing, let's start with annotating it. So for this, we need to have two annotations. One is at service, denoting that this is a service file, and next is going to be the required args constructor. If you don't have this, we need to like manually declare the constructor for each variable that we are using, so it's fine to have it. So first, let's just have a function. It's going to be public. And we are going to return the response. It's going to be of type string, okay? So it's going to be string. And let me just have it as get OpenAI response. OpenAI response. And we'll be just passing the prompt. So it's going to be string prompt. And yeah, so we can just remove this. Yeah. So basically from Postman, we'll be sending the prompt in the request body and getting back the response. So that's what this particular piece of code is going to do. So now for this code, we have already written it in our Java. So we can just go here. So this is going to be that parameter that we can copy and reuse. Basically this chat completion create params. So we can just copy this entirely. We don't want the OpenAI client because that's the stuff we have already declared in our config. So we don't want that. So we can just go here and paste it. So just come to the top above the function. It's going to be private final. We'll be using our config OpenAI client over here. So it's going to be OpenAI client and just have a variable OpenAI client. So I'm getting this warning, OpenAI client may not have been initialized, and add a constructor parameter. But I don't have to use that because I've already done required aux constructor. So the reason is because Lombok is not getting configured properly. So it can happen in some cases if you have just installed IntelliJ. So for this, you need to just go to settings, and you'll be having the plugins over here. And here we need to install Lombok. So as you can see, we are having Lombok getting recommended. So just install it and click on apply and okay. So now as you can see, that error has gone. So yeah, the code is fine. It's just we don't have the Lombok plugin over there. And now we can simply use this OpenAI client here, the exact same spot. That's it, no errors now. And the exact same stuff, we are having the prompt over here, but we need to change the prompt to the prompt that we are getting from Postman. So we can just replace this text portion with a prompt variable rather than hard coding it. And final change, we need to return this. We don't have to have this in a system like this. So you can either like return response, or what you can do is you can directly return this. Yep, clean code, no need to like waste a initialization of a variable. You can just do this. So that's basically it with our service file. Let's go to our controller. So same procedure, new file. So let me just name it as OpenAI controller, and it's going to be a class also. And here also, let's begin adding the annotations. First is we'll be having the @rest controller, denoting that this is a controller class. If you want, you can have a global level request mapping, or let me just have that also, why not. So it's going to be @request mapping, and let me just have it as /API/OpenAI. Yep, that's fine. And next, let me just have our service, because we need to like use the service file inside the controller. So it's going to be private final, which is OpenAI service, and OpenAI service. You can just have another annotation @required aux constructor. Yep, error has gone now. And finally, we can create our endpoint. So it's going to be public, and we can just have a response entity, and this is going to be of type string, and let's have a name. Let me just have it as getOpenAI response. Yep, that name would be fine. So we got some auto generated code. So here we need to do some changes. So we'll be getting the prompt from Postman's request body like this. We'll be having the prompt like this. So now for that, we need to have the request body annotation. So it's going to be @request body. We need to have this, and prompt is coming in, and here we are calling the getOpenAI response, which is this functions that we have that is returning the response, and that response is coming here, and we are just sending it back to the Postman. Simple stuff. And at the end, we need to also have a get mapping. So for the individual path, we can just have it as /response or /getOpenAI response, anything of your choice. So now we are done with the code. Let's just rerun our application. So the application has started on port 8080. So we can just like go to Postman, and here it's going to be get operation, change it to get, and just type http://localhost, and the port number is going to be 8080, change it. And here we need to copy this path, put it over here, /response, that's fine. And next, go to body, and in the body we need to have only one param, which is this prompt. If you want, you can just have a request model or something. So just go with prompt within double quotes and a curly bracket structure like this. And here we need to pass the prompt. Okay, I'll just go with the same one, essay on earth, this time 10 lines, something like this. And now I will just send it. So as you can see, I have got the response over here. So which means that our Spring Boot code is working perfectly. That's the video, guys. I hope you'd have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Learn a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.